Okay, it's been a few weeks since I painted the wall, and well, you can see it behind there. So now, I've still got two-thirds of the room to paint, like I had at the end of the last video, and I'm not that good or anything. But it occurs to me that I should, well, there's some little white specks here and there. I don't care that much about them because I'm going to put some clouds on there, just some billowy, puffy clouds. I took a couple of pictures on a sunny day a few weeks ago, and I'm going to use those as a rough guide. But basically, I'm just going to use a piece of my poster paper here to practice on, and I'm going to use my airbrush. It's a, what is it, Badger 155 that my darling wife bought me on sale years ago for her birthday or Christmas or something, and I've got some paint mixed up, which is just cheap dollar store craft paint mixed up 50-50 with water into the airbrush jar, and like so many things in this project, I haven't touched this airbrush in decades. So let's see how this works. See if I even remember how to use it. Oh yeah. That looks kind of cloudy. Ooh, a little bit of splatter there. That'll work. Hmm. I think if you do the clouds that look sort of like that, I was thinking I might have to put a big gray into some of them, but that's not too bad. How dark can I go before it looks unrealistic? Nah, maybe not. I think that'll work. Great, on to the real one. No going back now. Actually, there is going back. Anyway, screw it up. I just get the blue out and paint more. Paint over it. Paint makes an excellent eraser. Cartoony, but they're not bad. I'm going to carry on and I'll come back after I've done some more. I think that looks not too horrible. Maybe a little cartoony, but random enough to be cloudy. I think I can live with that. Now for the hardest part of this whole thing, cleaning the damn airbrush.